Ursula, and we have just spotted them riding down the road. He is in the solar-powered car. Tell me a little bit about your project.
Well, one way of looking to the car, it's an electric car. It has a bank of batteries that store power, an electric motor that drives the car, but instead of plugging into the wall to charge the batteries, we plug into the sun. The top of the car is covered in solar cells. The cells convert the light into electricity. Altogether, there are 893 cells. They generate about 900 watts. To put that in perspective, a toaster consumes about 1,000 watts. So with less energy than a toaster, we can charge the batteries on this car. And when the batteries are full, we can drive the car at night for 130 miles or during the day for 300 miles if it is a bright sunny day.
How fast does the car go?
Fast. Top speed 75.
I bet you've had a lot of people stop you on the road and ask them questions. I've seen cell phones come out, video players, everything trying to capture pictures. Tell me a little bit about how far you've gone so far on this project.
Well, the whole idea with the project is to promote the use of clean and sustainable energy. My take on it is that we're a bunch of hypocrites. We're all waiting for the government, someone or something to save the planet for us. It's not going to happen. I believe that this technology is clean and sustainable. We could be using today, but we lack the political will. So I decided to build a solar car and take on the greatest challenge on the planet for a solar car. Usually when you think of solar cars, you think of a tropical country in the middle of the summer on flat terrain. I decided to drive the car to the Arctic Circle. It's challenging to get there because the sun is low in the horizon, so not good quality light for a solar car. There's only one road to get there. It's a gravel road. And on that road, you cross the Continental Divide 3 times. So you're climbing very high mountains in order to get there. So I started driving the car last year in Buffalo, New York, drove around the Great Lakes, went all the way to the Arctic Circle. Then on the way south, I drove around Alaska, then I went south to San Diego, cut across to Key West. Now from Key West, I'm going back to the Arctic Circle.
In this car when you get out after a long distance? Is it very comfortable to ride in? You've gone quite a distance. How do you feel?
Well, so far we drove about 16,000 miles using only sunshine. The seat is molded to my body, so it's extremely comfortable. It's like someone hugging me, but without the smooshing.
Any chance of coming out with the SUV version?
Well, actually, I plan on using the know-how that I acquired developing this car into building a more practical vehicle. This is a demonstration vehicle. It's a lab on the wheels. Now, there is a lot of technology that has been developed for solar cars that can be applied and have been applied over the years into practical and everyday cars.
Well, thank you so much, Marcelo, for taking your knowledge and your passion for a clean environment and passing it on to us. We thank you and appreciate your efforts, and good luck to you.
Well, thank you for the opportunity, and for anyone watching, you can keep track of us on the website. That's www.xof1.com. And we're looking for volunteers and sponsors, so for anyone interested in becoming a volunteer, we'll supply you all the granola bars you can eat.
Sounds great.
Now, I have a video I can share with you of a girl running away from the solar car. So you're welcome to show that online, and we have some photos as well. If you have a memory stick, I can run to the computer and get that for you.
Thank you so much. We appreciate it. Check them out online.